Hello, I am John Rickerson. I am the research agronomist at the Hettinger Research Extension Center. We are clear in the southwest corner of North Dakota in a semi-arid environment, which means it's always either too wet or too dry. Kind of like Goldilocks, we can't find that really happy medium. Last year, a really wet year, even especially into the fall. This year, it's tough. We are very dry. We are probably 6 inches below our average moisture here. We've had only 1.25 inches of rain since the 1st of April. So unfortunately, my crops are looking a little tough, looking a little yellow because on top of that low rainfall, I broadcast urea very first part of April, and we just haven't had moisture to get that in the ground. So my small grains are looking a little yellow, short, they're heading out when they're only 18 inches tall. So, you know, tough climate, but that's how it is out here in the semi-arid. You know, we call it next year country for a reason, because next year will always be better. But we have what we deal with, but and we'll get some results and see how things respond when we're in a drought environment. A major part of the work that I do here is with variety trials. I have probably about 25 different variety trials out here with several different crops, dealing with winter wheat, spring wheat, durum, barley, oats. We have the pulse crops of chickpeas, field peas, lentils, canola, flax, safflower, corn, and sunflower. And then some various other minor crops like ginseng. We do have a hemp trial again here this year. So do some interesting alternative kind of things. So that's kind of the overview of the work we're doing there as far as variety trials. And then I also have been trying to ramp up the amount of agronomy work I'm doing. I have a soybean population study, which we'll be talking about in another segment. I'm also doing some work with a spring wheat seed treatment with the Dickinson Station. In fact, we just did root rot ratings on that. And actually this year we were seeing some interesting results. We're seeing some effectiveness of the fungicides versus the control. So Ryan Beto at Dickinson will hopefully have some more results on that as we get both those years combined. Also, we have a lentil study that's a multi-state grant working with Montana and here over several stations, where we actually are looking at lentil agronomy. So we're looking at some fertility inoculant things with lentils. And then we're also looking at seed treatments on lentils. And also we did some things where we did inoculate with fusarium and looking at variety response with lentils to the different, to the root rots. So that's kind of an overview of kind of the general things we do here. Our results are published on our website and of course on the NDSU Variety Trial page, and also look at those extension publications where you can also find that information for Hettinger. And of course, if you want to find out more information on the work we're doing or you have questions about crop production in the southwestern part of the state, certainly feel free to call us here at the Hettinger Research Station.